the Applesoft basic commands and so on listed in the text portion of the display. Okay, now when on non-Apple IIs, you would just get, non-Apple II GSs, you would just get the bytes. You would not get this ASCII translation. So that's one of the features of the 2GS monitor that sets it apart from earlier incarnations of the program. Okay. So how do you change memory? Well, you type in your address, you put a colon, and then you type in the value that you want to set at that memory. So you go to bit 16. I'm going to switch to bank 0 and then. You can also move data around using the M command, which takes the form of your destination address and a greater than sign, and then you type in the range of addresses that you want to move from, so the starting address from 1 and the ending address from 2, and then M. And it's going to copy that range of memory starting from the one value and ending at the other value. And then there's the Z command, which is the ZAP command, which fills a range of memory with the value that you put in. So to demonstrate those, so if you type in AA, So the move command is the same way. The arrow actually faces the other direction, which is not. You can search memory for different things. You can search a range of memory. And there, I think the arrows are actually going in the right way. You use a backslash, and then you type in your string of values, and another backslash, and you use the less than arrow. And again, you type in your range, and you use the P command. And you can also do an ASCII string if you put it in quote marks between the backslashes. You can use that. Say you're going to use that command to look for
I think you're missing the key.